Yo, what's good YouTube? It's Dom Too Much and I'm back here with another Bill video. And today we have the Kevin Durant Bill, which is honestly one of the toughest builds in this game just because of the fact of how tall he is, how good his ball handling is, and he's not that slow. He can really do everything, literally everything at a high level on the court. So getting right into it, you know, we got to put him at power forward. KD's true position is a small forward, but he also does play the power forward sometimes. Make him right-handed, and then jersey number, right now we're witnessing the best KD, and he's number 7. I was going to say that the best KD we've seen was number 35, but this season, he's going off this season. So moving on to his body, I put his height at 6'9". The reason I did this is because 6'10 just seems a little too slow for me, and Kevin Durant in real life, I believe he's about, honestly, 7 foot. But as you can see, that's way too slow for this build. And the attributes are just bad. So yeah, I put him at 6'9". And then minimum weight. And then we're going to take his wingspan to a 7 foot wingspan flat. And you get a 73 ball handle, 79 speed, 76 acceleration, 86 3-pointer, 89 drive and dunk. Which I think is pretty good for this build. And then I would make him, not slight, I would just make him compact. And then let's go over to the attributes. Drive and dunk. You know, KD is really good in the paint. We're not going to give him any close shot because we don't really need close shot on his build like that, and it costs way too much. So we're going to max out his drive and dunk, drive and layup. Take his standard dunk to a 65, and then put his post control all the way up to an 86. You get 17 finishing badges. Coming down to the shooting, you want to max out his three-pointer, max out his mid-range. And then not max out his free throw, but take it to an 89 to where you get 24 shooting badges. Or you can take it to 87 and save 2 more attributes. And then the pass accuracy, you want to put in at an 80. Max out his ball handling, max out his speed with ball, and you get 14 playmaking badges. We still have some attributes left, so max out perimeter defense, max out steal, max out block. And then don't max out his defensive rebound and just take it to an 88. You could put this to a 72, I believe. Coming down to this, you want to max out his speed, max out his acceleration, and then max out his stamina also. And you still got a few attributes left. So you can take some off his stamina, get one more badge there. Let's see if I can get it. You can get another playmaking badge also. But his vertical is a little low. Put his vertical at 66. Trying to see if I can get a little bit more shooting. Okay, so they're not letting us get more shooting. But you can get more playmaking if you feel like 14 is not enough. You can get 2 more playmaking badges if you like finesse his physicals a little bit. But I feel like 14 is pretty good for this build. So I would probably just bump his vertical up to a 70 and then max out defensive rebound, max out stamina, and then take this to 75, and there you have it. You get 17 finishing, 24 shooting, 14 playmaking, and 15 defensive badges, which is very, very good for this build, pretty much. And like you can do everything at a high level. You can dribble. You don't unlock pro dribble moves, but you can dribble. You get a 77 ball control at 99. You get a 93 pointer at 99. You unlock all contact dunks. You don't unlock Hall of Fame clamps, but gold clamps is just enough. You get Hall of Fame rim protector, Hall of Fame rebound chaser, Hall of Fame chase down artist. This build is nasty. Coming over to the takeover, as you can see, we get finishing, sharp, glass cleaning, and post takeover. But if you don't want glass cleaning and you want shot creating takeover, you just take these down a little bit to where you can still get 15, I believe, and then boost that up to 15. And you get playmaking now. So that's the way to get playmaking. Then you just take this down a little bit. Take your rebounding down to like an 87 until you can unlock one more. Let's see if we got it now. Yeah, so now you get slashing, shot creating, sharp, and post scoring. Which I like this setup, so I'm gonna go this way. Cause KD, real efficient from the post. definitely deadly from three. And then you know he can have any shot creating takeover because he's 7 foot. He doesn't see his defenders. He's shooting right over him, so he would have negative impact. And then slashing because KD can get to the rim, finish over you, finish through you, or just finesse you pretty much. So for this KD build, I would say I would go limitless primary. And then you can do like post shot dagger secondary for the post fades. Or I would do negative impact for other like fadeaway shots, so the defender contest really doesn't matter. But for this video, I will go post shot daggers. And then the name we get is a playmaking three level scorer, and you see the top comparison. We get the Kevin Durant comparison. I'm pretty accurate with these builds, man. Make sure, just for that, you have to drop a like, because I gave you the most accurate Kevin Durant build. Playmaking three level scorer, that is what KD is. Let's test out this build. Put him at a 99. His finishing badges. Gotta go Hall of Fame posterizer. Gold slithery. You can do something like Hall of Fame Heat Seeker Gold Acrobat. And then it's a lot that you can do with this build, honestly. Gold drop stepper, gold fearless. If you want to play more in the post, you can do something like back down punisher and then gold drop stepper. And take this down to gold and put drop stepper on Hall of Fame. Shooting badges, you can do gold hot zone hunter, gold deep threes, Hall of Fame hot shot. You really get a lot of shooting badges on this build. Hall of Fame blinders, gold difficult shots. You still have 7 shooting badges. Say silver catch and shoot, silver corner specialist, and then gold dead eye. To the playmaking, you get 14 playmaking badges. Not that much, but it is enough for this build because you don't need dimer. You would want bullet passer on bronze just to help with those like needle thread and passes. You don't need Hall of Fame handles for days. I would just put it on gold, put this on gold, and then you can do something like ankle breaker on gold and then take this to silver. Or if you just need a Hall of Fame badge, take that unpluckable down to silver, put handles for days on. And then Hall of Fame Space Creator, probably. I like that. Hall of Fame Space Creator, especially with the shot creating takeover, if you pick that. Coming over to the defense, I don't know if I would run clamps on this player because you're not going to be guarding ball like that. So you can put your attributes somewhere else. You got to go gold interceptor. Probably put on silver intimidator. Hall of Fame Rebound Chaser. Silver, and then maybe bronze. Maybe bronze like that. Silver rim protector, bronze pogo stick, bronze chase down artist. Yeah, I like this build, but this, if I had to pick a favorite build that I've built so far, I would probably say the Stephen Curry build because I really want to try that build out, but I already have a guard made. So the next build, I'm gonna drop a video on the next build that I'll be making. It's gonna be a big man because I haven't made a true big in a minute. So I would like to bring that experience back, and I'm going to be showcasing that for you guys. But yeah, if you made it this far, you know I messed with you. And also, make sure you subscribe if you're not subscribed. Get this video a like, and also let me know what builds you want to see next. It's Dom Too Much, and I'm out. Peace.